Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to describe and demonstrate about the phase shift oscillator. The phase shift oscillator generally represents a phase shift in which we are using a RC phase shift network in which a resistor and capacitance is connected across a common emitter configuration of a transistor. So in this type of configuration and in this type of oscillator, the phase of the input supplied is shifted to through 180 degree of the output phase. So we are going to demonstrate and describe this. So in this kit of trainer kit of phase shift oscillator, we first perform the phase shift which is in a normal mode, and then we perform the same experiment to observe the different frequencies on different capacitance value and keeping the resistance constant with the some different values, and then we perform the experiment with the improved values in which we add the three different networks by which we can improve the output frequency and output phase shift of this oscillations. So this is our trainer kit of phase shift audio oscillator which is working in a solid state, and the order code for this trainer kit is 36125. You can query about this, and to purchase this kit using this order code you can query and do the quotations about this kit. So on the front panel we have designed a basic common emitter configuration of two NPN transistors in which the resistance and capacitance network for phase shifting is provided. This is a knob for providing the different capacitance value from 1000 pf to 3300 pf and 6800 pf capacitance. So we are keeping the resistance constant. As the resistance value varies, this will vary the output distortions due to the tolerance is also varied by when we varied the resistance values. So this affects the output also. That's why we are only varying the capacitance value for this type of network. So also this is a gain setting potentiometer in which we will improve and accurate gain should be provided. So when the resistance and capacitance network increased in this system, this gain will compensate the output, and to get the proper output of the sine wave or the phase shift, we have to set the gain properly for all type of outputs. And this is a 9 volt supply provided, and this complete circuit works on the 220 volt power supply, and this is the power on off switch for power on and off the supply. So now we will going to connect the circuit to the power supply and then perform the experiment. So on, we are also providing a user manual for complete descriptions of experiment and to do the observation tables and to find out the different calculations regarding this circuit. So all the details about the circuit and the phase shift audio oscillator is provided in this user manual, and some patch codes to do the circuit connections in the accessories. So object 1 is to study the phase shift audio oscillator circuit using a single transistor. In this we will make the circuit described in the user manual. So this is the circuit in which we are using a RC network with a single transistor to provide the output of the phase shift, and this is the different capacitor value that we have selected with the knob provided on the panel, and then we observe the frequency and note down them to the observation table provided. So for different values of capacitor we will observe the frequency at the oscilloscope or the DSO, and also you have to calculate the frequency with the theoretical values provided in the user manual on the circuit. So we will now do the connections for the first experiment. For this we will connect the A point of this RC network with the E point to connect the first transistor, and C point will be connected with the E point as well. So this is our first connections. This is also described in the user manual. So these are the connection that has been done. Now we will provide power to the circuit and then observe output frequency from the different capacitance. Now after connecting the power, we will first set the knob to the 1000 pf resistor capacitance, and then we will power on the circuit. Now we will connect the DSO test probe to the circuit at the output terminals. Now our output is not showing at the CRO, so we have to adjust the gain, slightly increase the gain and observe the output whenever we get the output on the CRO. Here we have get the sine wave which has 180 degree phase shift, and the frequency is also, we have to adjust the gain properly to get the proper output of the oscillations. Now this is the sine wave output which has 180 degree phase shift, and the frequency is also calculated and observed on the CRO, which is 2.75 kHz for this 1000 pf capacitance. And now we will change the capacitance value from 1000 pf to 3300 pf. Also the phase shift is provided on the CRO, and for this the frequency has slightly down, which is now 915 hertz. So observe this frequency for different value. If you find the waveform is slightly distorted, you have to adjust the gain again and you will get the proper sine wave like this. So now we will change the value again to the 6800 pf, and at this time we are getting the frequency is 440.7 kHz. So this is approximate frequency changes accordingly, and this have to be mentioned in the observation table provided on the user manual. So you have to enter the frequency for each of the capacitance value, and this frequency will be mentioned in this observation table, and then you have to compare the frequency by calculated value of the frequency. So this is our first practical, then we move on to the second practical. Now moving on to the second object, to study the improved phase shift audio oscillator circuit using two transistor. In this type of circuit we will use the two transistor for this, and the assembling circuit given and the procedure is also given in the user manual, and you can also see the connection diagram provided on the figure 7 on the user manual. So we have to add the first capacitor for this and first transistor for this type by connecting A and B, and for second transistor we will connect capacitance and resistance network for also, and by connecting D by E and F. So this will change the circuit to the two transistor improved phase shift audio oscillator. So we will do the circuit like this. For this we will connect A point, which is RC network, with the B point, and E point will be connected with the D point, and also we will connect F point with the D point as well, E point as well, sorry. And now we will connect the CRO on the output terminal. And after adjusting the gain, we will get the proper frequency output. And this time we are getting some improved output of the oscillations. So we are getting the frequency for 1000 pf as our capacitance selector switch is at 1000 pf. For the 1000 pf we are getting 2.57 kHz frequency. Now we will change the capacitance dial to the 3300 pf. At this we are getting frequency of 8035 hertz, but you can see the waveform output or 180 degree phase shift is also improved in this type of configuration. And now we'll change the capacitance value to the 6800 pf, and at this time we are getting the frequency 400 hertz, and the output is more accurate. So if you find output is slightly distorted, you have to adjust the gain and you will get the proper frequency output. Here as I increase the gain, the output slightly distorted, and as I decrease the gain and adjust the value properly, you will get the proper frequency output. So this is how we do the practical with phase shift audio oscillator. So the observed frequency should be mentioned for each value of capacitor in the observation table, and you have to calculate the theoretical value of the frequency by putting the all accurate values of resistance capacitance, and then we can compare the calculated value with the observed frequency should be in distortion. Some deviation of the observed frequency from the calculated value is due to the component tolerance, so deviation should be around 10% due to the loading effects of the described in the theory section of this manual as well. So this was the sum of experiment of phase shift oscillator, in which we have found out the 180 degree phase shift of the input sine wave frequency, and the frequency changes when the capacitance value also changes. And to improve the output, we have introduced another transistor in the circuit. So by two transistor method in the common emitter configuration, we can find out the improved phase shift also. So this is about all this practical and the standard kit. And while doing the practicals and referring the manual, if you find any difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.